Hello there, it's your boy from 1996, Redmond Fullerton Disintegration. Anyways, welcome back to another episode of Low Standards, where you'll find some interesting games, weird games, strange games, and games you didn't even know existed. Anyways, decided to whip out one of my plug-and-plays, the Star Wars Clone Wars Republic Squadron motion game. Anyways, that's Pacific and Hutchins, saw the intro art, splash art. Anyways, we're going to be playing at least, I think, a few levels. I love this plug-and-play in particular because it was a plug-and-play that seemed really unique for me. And then I saw an episode of Jon's Starcade. Anyways, the game goes for two perspectives, where you control a starfighter in certain sections, and the air sections you control it like a on-rail shooter, kind of similar to the Trilogy arcade game, or that one Star Wars arcade game that got released a few years back. I got this for Christmas, because, you know, I mainly just asked for Christmas, because I asked for it a bunch of times, but, you know, never got it until 2 years prior, and it's been a fun game to play, no matter what. But yeah, the controller is entirely motion control, which is really cool. So it's like the first time I really see a plug-and-play use motion controls, unless it's like a dance pad or one of those weird, like, camera game ones. But the games are so abysmal that they're not really worth even buying or checking out. But I'll get them anyways, because plug-and-plays are super cheap these days, even more cheaper than I thought it would be, because most of the ones I've been getting as of late back then, before, you know, the whole thing happening this year, was getting it specifically at, this one, like, community thrift store. You can't even shoot that guy. They tell him that, like, oh, look out, Blue 5, you're under attack. But at the same time, you can't really target that area, which makes no sense to really just warn me about it. Oh yeah, like in the Star Wars arcade game, usually there's reticles telling you which fighter is particularly attacking you. This one kind of goes less on how many fighters can attack you. There are some times where you're actually dealing with full-on firing squadrons, I think by the last few missions. But in this one, they most likely just have fighters every now and then to shoot you, but it's like one fighter only. Not like a squadron of fighters. If not, there's usually like only like one squadron. Like, one fighter in the squadron shooting at you. Oh, frig me. The only ones you most likely play a lot more would be the ones that are more arcade-esque. This one's definitely up there, per se, but this one's a lot more intuitive with their things. I realize that it's not really 3D graphics, but really cool detailed spraying for this one. The only way it seems so interesting with its perspective is probably because of the backgrounds being so empty and black voided, which really pops the fighters in play. Okay, this one wants to destroy 30 fighters. So go ahead and destroy them all. And another one. Got him. Oh, I didn't shoot a guy. No, yeah, that guy got dead. If I was fully healed, I would have gotten a lot more points with that bonus. I was saying hello to my sister opened the door in the room. Oh well. Alright, now I gotta destroy a Sarge Ventress's fighter. Which I mainly destroy with the usage of bombs. Zod's Vantage is ship is always at, like, a lower percentage of health, so that's good. Oh, got send a signal. Alright, it's gonna hold it like this. Thank you. So that's a different look detail. That's good. So that makes it so it's almost like a cool forced 3D perspective. Well, I managed to shoot her down with a bomb, I think, before that Viper bomber just came into play. Ah, dang it, so close. I almost got her. Oh, that's a lot of fighters. Oh, I got her. Pitiful Jedi, I bid you farewell. My voice for Ventress kind of sounds like Frieza. Let's see. You know what? We'll do one more level. We're gonna do the, actually, I'm gonna go backwards. Oh, wait, hold on. Let me go. I have to wait for a second. Let's go exit mission. Yes, whatever. I'm gonna go do the last portion of the mission where you're controlling the, turrets, on the, veterinary cruiser that appears at the end of the mission I just skipped. Banking Clan. Oh yeah, I forgot the Banking Clan is involved with this. I got to destroy at least a few 55 Vulture droids. Sorry, man. I gotta take your kills. That's pretty nice. This is something I don't think you actually do in the Star Wars arcade game, and that's controlling a turret rather than controlling just the fighters in combat. Save you. Alright, with those fighters destroyed, I think I'll be able to destroy the dreadnought. Oh wait, no, never mind. I'm now being attacked by hyena bombers. I know my Star Wars so well. I don't want to brag about it, though, because, you know, people will brag about their speciality, someone's going to call them out, saying, hey, this guy's a cop-out. Ooh, that was close. I was going to destroy that line. Uh-oh, incoming. Gotcha. Without your commander, the ace pilot at all. Aw, too late to save us that guy. Uh-oh. Gotcha! Aw. Wait, no, I got him! That was too late. Alright, uh-oh. I got some fires. Did I get all of them? No. I did not. I'm almost dead. Unlike the fighters, I can't heal my health with the recharging station because I'm a turret. Oh, I gotta save that guy. Alright. What was that? Oh, the Y-Bombers are shooting now. The Y-Wings have now destroyed the shields. Now I can destroy the Dreadnought this time. Yeah, I just need to keep shooting at it. I was gonna be careful though, because I'm almost dead. Alright, almost there. I can take a hit. Yeah, I did it! Now give me that explosion. Give me that pixelated explosion. Give me that pixelated explosion. Come on, do it! Oh, we're almost there. Yeah! Pixelated explosion. Alright, that's it for today. I'll see you next time. Bye.